During the end of the fur trapping era, from 1840 until 1860, there is little documented use of the valley. The reports of the fur trappers describing the beautiful and wild natural resources in western Wyoming had not gone unnoticed. In the years before the Civil War ended, the West was a relatively unknown area to the United States government. After the war, when the homesteading acts were signed, a heavy wave of settlement spurred the need for surveys. Their primary purpose was to map, evaluate, and record potential routes for transcontinental railroads. These expeditions brought back numerous reports of the vast amount of untapped natural resources. The three largest and most famous were the Cook-Folsom-Peterson Expedition of 1869, the Washburn-Langford-Doane Expedition of 1870, and the Hayden Geological Survey of 1871. The reports these three expeditions produced are credited with the founding of Yellowstone. The geysers, bubbling mud springs, and steam vents they encountered were otherworldly. The question of how to protect these resources became a priority. The Hayden expedition was the first to incorporate a photographer and an artist alongside the cartographers, geologists, and botanists. The images William Henry Jackson and Thomas Moran produced are invaluable. These were the first recorded images of the Yellowstone and Jackson Hole areas and depicted the value of these areas in ways that words could not. A stunned Congress viewed the now iconic landscapes of northwest Wyoming and created Yellowstone, the nation's first national park, in March of 1872. Although the age of discovery is widely believed to have ended at this point, it was only just beginning. In the succeeding years after Hayden's famous expedition, millions would journey to this once remote corner of the continent to see for themselves the awe-inspiring landscapes. Many enter under the now famous Roosevelt Arch, the northern gateway to Yellowstone National Park that pronounces the land to be for the benefit and enjoyment of the people.